We're heading up to Mendenhall Glacier today to do a drone survey of Suicide Basin, and also going to service a couple of GPS receivers that we have up there. And we are doing the drone surveys to try and understand how the basin is changing over time and how much water is in there at this particular moment.
Look like it's melting out. I wonder if we should just land over here.
And the GPS receivers are to try and understand how much ice is flowing into the basin, which is part of understanding how the basin is changing over time. This is a steam drill. It is basically a pressure cooker. So we've got a little propane canister connected to a, if I open this up, it would look like a camp stove. And then there's just a container that has a seal on the top. So we're building up enough pressure to turn it, to get a lot of steam. And then once we have enough pressure, we can send the steam through the hose and then drill into the ice using that steam. And then the idea with that is we can attach, or we can put poles into the ice and attach the GPS antenna to that. So we got enough steam coming out of the steam drill, and I'm just gonna stand here for about 10, 20 minutes while it drills downward. It's shooting steam into the ice. We can get down to like 15 meters with this. We'll put in three poles, and then there's gonna be a wood platform that goes between the poles that holds the GPS antenna. And then with the GPS receivers, we can get an idea of how fast the ice is flowing in and how that's changing over time.
Start operation.
We're out here on Mendenhall Glacier flying a drone survey over Suicide Basin, and we're trying to understand how the Mendenhall Glacier ice dam is changing over time as it's calving into Suicide Basin. So we come out here every couple of weeks to fly a drone survey, which we turn into a digital elevation model of this glacier, the calving front, and the basin itself to keep track of the topography and the water level. It's a pre-programmed flight path that it's basically just flying back and forth and back and forth, kind of like mowing your lawn. It takes approximately 2,000 pictures of this entire scene. We stitch those 2,000 images together. We're trying to keep track of how the basin is enlarging over time. So go back to 2010 and this side basin was entirely filled with ice and didn't have any volume to fill up with water seasonally. And so over time, this calving front that we're standing on Mendenhall Glacier has slowly retreated towards us and has allowed more and more of the basin to fill with water annually. What the drone surveys actually allow us to do is look at the icebergs above water level, and we can then estimate that approximately 10% of the icebergs are above freeboard, and so we can estimate the ice volume in the basin and the water volume in the basin. And over time, over many years, the trend has been more water and less ice. So that is part of why we continue to do these drone surveys, is to keep track of new icebergs calving into the basin and try to provide as accurate of estimates of water volume as we can. The more real-life data you can plug into your numerical ice flow models, the better they'll perform. So that's the goal in the next 2 years, is to collect as much ice velocity and melt data as we can, and then use historical data sets to kind of calibrate these flow models so we can say with more certainty how long Suicide Basin is likely to be a problem in coming decades.